12-12 Vision, man.
12-12 Vision Channel.
12-12 Vision.
Yo, this is 12-12 Vision Channel. It's your boy 12. 12-12 Vision. I'm out here in Soho on the side of Stadium Goods. Show them Stadium Goods real fast. We out here chilling. That's Da Vinci. Show them Da Vinci. He out here doing bad stuff. Stop that, Da Vinci. Get off that off my channel. We don't promote none of that negative on the channel. So I wanted to say to y'all, I wanted to show y'all my little drip today. Hold on, let me pull my little tinglings out. Hold up. My birthday just passed too. Today the 4th, I'm gonna post this.
Nah, happy birthday, my guy. Yo, happy birthday. You know the vibe,
yesterday.
What?
Yeah.
You see you yesterday?
Yeah, I know, I was with the family. Yeah,
you ain't seen that? Nah. That's a fact,
You know, I'm an enclosed person. I appreciate y'all doing that. I appreciate you just calling me today and saying, yo, what up, pull up, meet up.
But I ain't call you yesterday?
Nah, it's all right. You my guy.
Oh, it was before yesterday.
It was yesterday, my birthday.
No, but I called you before yesterday.
You called
me today. Pull up early.
Told me to close early.
What
you talking about? All right, so I want to show y'all my drip. So my birthday was on June 3rd. I just made motherfucking 33 today. You feel me?
I'm old. Oh, 33? Okay.
Yeah, I'm kind of old out here to keep it 100. You feel me? You know what it is. So what it is my drip right now. Boom, look at the feet. Thank you.
Right.
Bring it up. Got my little right here. I don't even know the name of this right here, but I like it. Go with the little Travis right now. My little chrome hard hat and shit like that. My little shingalings and stuff like that, because I'm feeling good. It's June. It's my Gemini. All my Gemini seasons. What's up, Gemini? YouTubers. What's up, YouTube? It's your boy 12-12-12 Vision of the channel. Y'all know the vibes. If y'all didn't subscribe, subscribe. 12-12 Vision, we out here on Mercer in Soho. I'm on my booster board right now. Booster boarded. We on Mercer right now. I'm going to just show y'all the Mercer vibes after hours, after work hours, after what? Let me see the people that work in VFAL, Stadium Good. Mercer's always lit with traffic. Show them the traffic. It's always backed up with traffic. The young boys, the stylish boys is always out here, fresh to death, smoking up a storm. We'll show y'all the future, the youth out here in Mercer. 12-12 Vision, the channel. Y'all know the vibes. If y'all ain't subscribed, subscribe. Hit that like button and subscribe. 12-12 Vision.
Out here, yeah. Say that for me again. Y'all know the vibe, right?
It's good, YouTube.
That's for fact.
Yeah.
It's the young crowd that'll be out here in Mercer. Thank you, bro. Yeah, because got something the latest on, good Travis on for the, you know what I'm saying? You know how I give it up. I'm gonna go over here to my boy Park Ave. Yo, shout your job out. Look how, I got home team out here. Mike out here, what's up? You see boys doing what they do. What's up?
Out here.
What's up? What up, Mike? Mike, this is my home team. What's up, boy? I'm out here on Mercer, just doing what we do. Boy Park Ave working, what's the name? Origins right here.
Check me, Origins NYC.
Y'all know the vibe.
It's like round two, but with designer.
With designer.
You feel me?
Heavy.
So everything you could do at round two, you could do with us.
That's a fact.
But you could also bring and buy that designer. Come get that drip. Come get, you
shout
know,
your, shout your Instagram out on here.
Instagram, park_AV_. Come check me, you already know the vibes.
I'm gonna put that up there, yes, you sir. Already know. I'm out here with my guys, show y'all how Mercer look. Even the other side, this is VFALS right here. The other side, people over there macking, just chilling. Over there talking to the shorty right here. Homeboy over here macking. Then you got the other crowd over here, gang it. Yeah, you know it, stylish. Everybody in their own world. This is what the camera do. Mercer. On a Tuesday, you know what I'm saying? You got people up here, chilling.
Regular day, out here on Mercer, your boy 12-12-12 Vision. Y'all know the vibes right now, just relaxing. Got off of work, after hours in Soho, NYC vibe. All my subscribers, subscribe. Got my booster board out here, boosting. And that's what I'm gonna do, jump on the booster board. See you in a second.
This Palace too. Palace, Stadium Goods. Where people just chilling, hanging out, eating, lunching, smoking, breaking. This is Soho, this is Broadway right here. This is the street Broadway. You see Champion across the street right there. It's Broadway we on right now with the traffic going down. I'm gonna take y'all to Origins real fast, see what's up in Origins. That's what we gonna do. Walk in Origins, see what's going on. I'm waiting for the traffic to chill. Don't wanna get hit on a booster board. All right, we out. Excuse me, buddy. Thank you, bro. Thank you. Nice. This canal we headed up on in a drop top. I like your jacket in that drop top, bro. For sure. Drop top flow. That's NYC shit. This is canal traffic on a Tuesday with the people. You dig? Look at this canal traffic. NYC be wildin' with this traffic. Out of control. This is where Origins is right here up on my left. Pulling up right now. Straight up. OG. Gonna run up in Origins real fast, see what it's hitting for. Up in Origins right now, say what up to the gang. Shout out yourself. What up, y'all? Up in Origins, it's the Origin. Yo. What's up, my guy? What's good?
How are you?
I'm chilling, YouTubing right now.
Sure.
What's good? What's up, fly guy? Taking care of business. Origins always popping on a Tuesday. It's the boss man right here. Origins taking care of business. How you doing? This shit is always jam rocking. Here's the other boss man in Origins right there. You already know. Origin is lit. This shit is fire. You know what I'm saying? Heavy drip. Say that again.
Gotta have that bag coming up in here. Don't play with it. Heavy drip in here.
Heavy drip. You ain't never lie. That's Origins for you though, boy. They got everything. Shit is fully loaded up in here. You know what I'm saying? In Soho for you. And they got Winter Gear, Supreme Heavy. Like you said, it's that bag talk right here. You gotta have some bread for these tees. That big Supreme collection.
Michael Berry.
Yeah, the high end too.
Look at the foot. You got the footwear.
Ooh, lubes on. Fucking do that. Oh, you got the Dior's heavy too, you heard? Pull up, Chanel's and all at the Origins. Heavy on the J's. Boss man Chuck, how you doing, Chuck? How's everything? That's one of the homies right there, good fella. But this is Origins for y'all. On a chill day, you feel me? On a good Tuesday. Had to come show y'all Origins. I don't pull up in Origins often, so show y'all the gang up in Origins. Park Ave outside taking this lunch break.
Like real, this is real fly shit that's in the.
And we got the business, you heard?
You know what I'm saying?
Why they playing with you though?
Why they playing with you?
Why they playing with you? Show the boo boo. Show the boo boo. Show the boo boo. Yeah.
Hold on.
Hold on.
Always love, good energy over here, right?
You already know what it is, how we rocking VJ 650 World.
That's
right now, we rocking on the block.
Nigga, put your gram up there. Regular day out here, right?
You know what I mean? Gang shit.
650V, man.
You already know what it is.
My guys right here.
You already know it's Cape Flip the ID, hailing from Harlem World. Nigga, you already know. We out here.
Put these boys at Instagram up there. Y'all add them and follow their whole movement. Because both of these boys is really making movements. That's not making moves. They making movements. Like tapping to their fucking sound. Like I'm going to put
the fuck in.
Real talk. Like I'm going to throw
tap
this shit up.
Before I tap your bitch.
Yeah, you are. That's a you fact. That's big facts. You know what I'm saying? A regular day out here, though. This is natural, though. My guys. 12-12 vision, 12, fucking
12
with the
vision, man.
Fucking with the game.
Feel me? 12-12 vision.
That's a fact,
that's
boy. Good looking, y'all.
You already know. Look over here.
What's up, Laga? How you doing?
You guys shooting?
No, I'm just watching them shoot. I'm out here. You got Jungle Boy Joe over here with his crew.
Gang, gang, gang.
That is very true.
Uh-huh.
And I'm going to show you one why he's over here. He's the owner of this. You see that Supreme in the back of that right there? He's the owner of that. If you go into the store right here, matter of fact, I'm going to take y'all into the store. So gay friendly store right here. It's pretty cool. Broadway Market. Going in. I'm going to show y'all Joe part. Mad designers, mad jewelers. There's some fly stuff in here. It's really nice. Come get some art, some streetwear. A whole lot of streetwear. It's fire in here. So I'm going to take you out of my boy Joe, who was just... I took the long way to show y'all everything. Supreme! This is with my man Joe. He owns down here. Nice. This is actually nice. Is he doing it? Let me see.
No, he ain't try it.
You ain't try it? You about to try it?
No.
You scared? Don't be scared. Y'all never know. Scared money don't make no money. Y'all resellers?
Yeah, I'm reselling.
You a reseller? Oh, you my man. We just talking about the skating. It's my buddy right here. How you doing? Oh, this is fire inside of here. Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to mess the picture up. Big crazy. This is, ooh, nice. This is the inside of it. Got hats, art. This is Joe Park in here. Pretty dope. Pretty nice. My guy. Why would they do that to that Off-White? That shit must be fake. I don't know. I'm gonna go ask him right now. Jungle Boy Joe, you're beautiful.
What's up, baby?
Yo, why would you burn that Off-White? Explain that to me.
Oh, we burn that because we don't sell fakes.
Oh, I knew it was a fake, yeah. So you're a real guy for that.
I'm a real nigga.
Much
and
respect
guess what?
To you.
Son paid 3 bands for that.
Did he?
3 bands.
He got hit?
He got hit. And guess what? He got no bread from me.
Wow.
We burnt him.
Burnt it.
He got 500 followers. What's that worth to you?
You funny, Joe. But yeah, that's my man. I just showed y'all the inside store.
Oh, you did that for me?
Yeah, why wouldn't I, Joe?
Yo, that's all love, bro.
Jungle Boy Joe, that's what they call him.
Jungle Boy Joe. I'm changing the IG name right now.
Yes. Everybody that knows the 1212 Vision know this kid right here. What up? What up, Da Vinci's World? How you doing, Clean Chrome Heart? Look at this feast. This kid got $2,000 feast because he's one of the biggest resellers out here, right? State your name, Da Vinci. How you doing? You silent today?
I'm with you.
It's all good. It's good seeing you.
Yeah,
you
heard?
Don't worry about that. You one of the realest out here. You know that, right? You elite. Favorite word. That's him.
Da Vinci.
Da Vinci's world. Got you. My man right here on Mercer. My name is 1212 Vision, and I'm gonna ask you to subscribe. He's out here with his beautiful lady. Ow! And he did a real nice with the biggest Uniqlo t-shirt. Did you? Do they have the dolls still?
Nah, bro.
They don't have the dolls.
They
sold out.
They sold out mostly everything.
Mostly everything.
So yeah, but
what kind of t-shirt did you get?
This one, bro.
Ooh, fire! Fire! That's dead fire, bro. Dead fire. Cause Uniqlo t-shirt, right? It's a Cause Uniqlo collab, right?
Yeah, bro.
It's really nice. Good cop today, bro. I appreciate you stopping and letting me get you on it.
Feet on.
We all got good feet. Now, those is calm feet. Those are real good feet.
Not good feet. Calm feet.
Those are good feet. You bugging. Those are wild comfortable. You bugging. Those New Balance are good feet.
What's up?
About you.
Come on, sir. What he said.
BBC is right here. Them steps, but yeah, let's go on BBC real fast. People coming up out of BBC, going BBC and shit. Oh, almost fell walking up in the BBC. BBC, crispy. Fly shit in BBC, you heard? Damn, this shit is wild dope inside. Heavy on a Moral Carnby. Human made. Fire.
Sorry, you can't record.
You can't record it?
You can't record it.
No recording? I'm Yo, say, how you doing, Mar? Look, what's they up? Love her, Mar. Yeah, look, she out of there. Yo, talk. Why you don't want to talk to me and Martin? She got a body that camera, right? What's up, Martin? How you doing?
It's good.
I see you get the love out here, Martin.
Where you running for?
You the man on Howard. This the man that run Palace right here. Y'all see Palace. We can't record inside there. So you gonna do this. Ah, the big P. And y'all see the trifecta. And it's right next to Stadium Goods. We could go in here with the camera. You feel me? I'm gonna go in here. See what's up in the stadium. I'm shaking, my bro. Chilling. Stadium Goods flow. Oh, the boss man up in here. Good fella. I'm showing you how Stadium Goods look on a cool day. Heavy on the feet. Heavy. Regular day, stadium, Soho.
Problem child, we out here. That memories, not dreams.
That
memories,
not dreams. That were memories, not dreams.
Boom. Show him the turquoise one.
I got you, right?
Yeah.
We had the black one song that.
Oh, that's fire. That is fire. Yes, it is. How much are your t-shirts?
Oh, t-shirts, they go from 40.
40, yep. But today is 38. You get it from the streets, no shipping.
Yeah, say that again.
We do it in New York. You know, we have a store in New York. We have a stock list, 40 Clinton Street, Sandre. But, you know, we in New York, we selling them.
You in the streets, beating the streets up,
yes,
right now,
yeah,
pretty
we
much.
That's them, the... you know, we feeding the streets what we supposed to do.
Exactly.
Problem Child New York all day.
Problem Child New York. So I'm going to tell y'all, everybody that's on my channel, follow that brand right there. I'm going to add them and show y'all on Instagram they name, they store brand. Right. And they got Victor Cruz in it too, right?
Yep.
All right,
shout out to Tim Vick, man.
Yeah.
Shout out to 12 as well.
I appreciate you, bro. Y'all got some real nice pieces, and what I'm gonna do is right now I'm gonna shop a piece. What size are they?
Size? We got mediums and large.
I'm like I'm medium or large. So what colors? What other colors do you have?
We got orange. This is my favorite one.
The orange one.
Orange. It's inspired by Inmate.
Yeah.
The prison back in the Philippines. So this is pretty much what you know.
That's really, yeah, that is fire.
And it says in the back, David Memories,
Ooh,
Not Dreams.
That is nice. That's really nice. You know, it really is.
David Memories, Not Dreams, baby.
That's a big fact.
Get the green one. The green one is good. This one is also good.
Who do the designing? You do the designing? Yeah. So you the co-designer and everything.
So this guy, he was from my country.
Yeah, what country are you from?
Philippines, man.
Philippines.
So
shout out to the Philippines.
Filipinos, man.
Yep, all the Filipinos.
Yo, so this guy, he was actually an ex-drug addict.
Yeah.
And when I met him, he was sober for years, and he was saved by art. I met him at the Art Foundation that we have in the Philippines.
Okay.
So he's pretty much like helping out the kids out there.
He inspires you.
So this, like, you know, I got inspired by him.
Mm-hmm.
So that was Memories, Not Dreams.
That's another nice one, New York. Yeah, Problem Child. Yeah, remember, again, follow Problem Child.
Problem Child, New York. Check out the sock, man.
Nice. Problem Child, New York. Big drip, y'all. Nice to meet y'all, fellas. So what is it, spelled out straight out? Problem Child, New York?
Problem Child, New York.
No underscore anything?
No underscore, Problem Child, New York. You'll see it, the black logo, Problem Child, New York. You know what? Hold up.
Zoom in on that.
People got confused. This one over here.
Wait, let me see, put it down a little bit. All right. Hold up. Okay, this is it right here.
That's this one.
And that's Vic right there. Yep.
15. It's not Vic, but it's like, you know, it's my boy Chino. Right.
Let me see that one. Go back to that one. That's nice.
It's a nice one. Nice piece.
Yes, it is.
Nice piece. But we have a bucket hat. We sold out.
Bucket hat?
Yes.
Let me see the logo again on Instagram.
There we go. Black one right there.
Black one. Problem Child New York.
I'm a child New York, man.
Got you, bro.
Shout out to 12, man. Thank
you. Appreciate
so much.
You, man. Y'all got some dope product right now.
Thank
I'm
going
to cop
you.
Me a piece right now as we speak.
So I'm going to put it back in the package for you.
I'm not sure if it's going to be orange or one of them cute colors.
It's one of them cute colors.
Yeah, this is like, right?
One of my favorite, man. It's Inmate. It's Inmate.
Alright,
you know, I got locked up for 2 days, that's why.
I ain't gonna lie to you, I'm into this color, I'm into this right here.
The orange one is good also.
It is. So you know what?
The orange one in M.
This one is pretty much my dream, my guy.
Yeah, I like this, but you know what? Yeah. This can go with the, I throw the pink ones in. So this is it right here, when I throw the pink shoelaces.
If you, get them right now, you know, it's 35, my friend.
Alright, well, I got them getting it right now. Thank you.
35, man. You know, it's all love, respect, and...
You back me up? Thank you, bro. 1212 Vision, we out here on Mercer. This is live on Mercer, Soho. Every day, this is a quiet Tuesday. We support all, how can I say it, entrepreneurs. That's what we all out here, because I'm a YouTuber. Shout out to all my YouTubers. Shout out to the entrepreneur right here that got his own brand, which it is. Say it again.
Problem Child New York.
Problem Child New York. We in the heart of the New York right now, which is Soho.
Pre-Kush Conversations with Kasha.
Pre-Kush Conversations with Kasha. And YouTube, I apologize for having this on my channel because, you know, I ain't with this smoking stuff, but this is Unkasa. He's a famous, y'all know who Unkasa is. Yo, Un, what up? We on 1212 Vision?
What up, what
y'all? Ain't nothing, man. Talk to him, Un. What you had to say? You just talking a whole lot just now.
Man, it's like...
You into fashion? You into fashion now, Un? You be talking about fashion
I'm into
to me
fashion,
about...
Man. Let me tell y'all what I learned about fashion.
What you learned about fashion? We in Harlem, too, y'all. Look at the camera and say what up one time.
What up, what's up? It's your boy, Kasa.
You good, nigga. You clean cut, nigga.
What I learned about fashion is... Fashion is born every day.
It's born every day?
Fashion is born every day. Fashion is born with the idea. Fashion is not always luxury, neither. You can be fresh with the most ran down Chuck Taylors, most dirtiest Vans, most ripped up jeans. You can be fly like that.
Yes, you can.
What happened in the fashion game, they put so much emphasis on luxury than they was actually doing style. Like, you can go to a store and get something dead ass ugly that is not appealing to the eye, that's not attractive, but because the name of it, you'll buy it. And somebody else know just how much it costs and what the name of it is, makes it dope. Instead of that, the actual style or the texture or the fabric of the clothes is dope. You can actually buy something that you wouldn't normally buy on your own, but because you seeking attention from a certain fashion aspect, you'll buy that. Like me, I don't like the Balenciaga sneakers. I would never wear them. Even if somebody gave them to me, it's just not my style of dressing.
Why? What's wrong with that, though? I'm sure some of them are fire, though.
No.
What about the uncomfortable ones, the, like, sock shit? Not the big...
Those is cool.
The Gore-Tex ones is all right,
too. I just feel
too.
Like a lot of people that wear them wouldn't normally do that.
Or they just following the trend?
Yeah, they follow the trend.
That is true. That's,
you know,
very
what I'm saying?
True.
Not that I say the sneaker was whack. I didn't even say the sneaker is ugly. I just wouldn't wear them because normally that's not what I wouldn't wear.
But things is changing, though. We're in the future, bro.
Oh, the future? It's cool. I love it, but like I said, everything is not for everybody. That's not my preference in dressing. You know what I'm saying?
All
right. I'm on to an athletic sneaker. And don't get me wrong, I like some of the Balenciaga sneakers and shit, because some of them, even some of the big sold sneakers is dope. But I feel like a lot of people would just put it on just because...
It's the hottest name brand out
that's
right
it,
now.
Instead of what it actually, you know what I'm saying?
For the quality of it.
But I've seen a lot of stuff that's actually not appealing to the eye or even look dope and people wearing it just because of what the name is. I want to bring fashion back to where what you actually rocking is dope and you're okay. comfortable. You know what I'm saying? Mm. I don't feel like you dope if you walking around looking like 100 other people.
It's true.
I want to come out. I want you to come out and feel you as a fashion individual. I don't want you to be able to go in a club and might see somebody with the same shirt that you got on because it's a big name brand. You know what I'm saying? I want you to be able to walk into a club and got some shit on that
you don't see too many people
with. And if you know, if you do see somebody with it on, you know it's some rare shit. Right. And he deserved to have that shit on because it's not many of them.
I mean, there's pieces out there. There's people out there actually like that with some fire shit. Like,
nah, it's a lot of dope ass designers. Pieces, yeah. Like even, well, I learned a lot from Slow Bucks.
Yeah, Slow what? Slow is crazy with the club.
Like, I learned a lot of Slow. It's like, even when I first started Cranberry and Vodka, I learned a lot. I seen when Slowna was coming up, they clothing line became a clothing line.
Because, it was more like a movement.
And it wasn't it wasn't even meant to be a clothing line. It was viral wear. It was really to promote their website.
Yeah. Oh, they had a website?
Yeah, they had slowbucks.com. It was just viral wear to promote their brand as a whole.
Yeah.
But then they had got with some guy that actually was matching them with sneakers and showing them all type of colors of vinyls. So they was taking the vinyls with the Slow Bucks sign and matching them to the kicks. And when I started my line, I was like, damn, I know that's a wave right there, because a lot of people will come out, a lot of sneakers will come out and you won't have nothing to wear with them. You know how many pairs of kicks niggas got sitting in their crib and holding on to them because they don't really got a fit to wear with them?
Mm-hmm.
And I seen the opening right there. It was like, shit, what if I just start making sweatsuits that's matching all the new kicks that's coming out? And that's like my first summer, first year of me doing that, I probably sold like almost 1,000 pieces.
I mean, not too many people know you got a clothing line, but they do because you got the Instagram. What is your clothing line? Huh?
Cranberry and Vodka.
Cranberry and Vodka? Like, mm-hmm. It's spelled with a K, right?
Spelled with a K. You know what I'm saying?
I'm going to put that up here right now.
It's really street apparel, sweatsuits, t-shirts.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? I got like collector's item pieces as far as like pens and special like little item, but I'm really just getting really hipped up on how the merch game is ran. When I first started my apparel line, I just wanted to get niggas fresh. I really didn't know the aspect of what a fashion game, how the fashion shifts, how this trend can be hot this week and next week we on to something else. But now I know how to project my brand into all different lanes. That's why I never limit my creativity. At first, I was like, yo, I'm just doing sweatsuits and tees. I want to do blazers. I want to do golf shirts. I want to do pants. I want to do racing sets and stuff like that. But it was just like, at the time, I ain't have to really have the knowledge or the outlets to these shops and little, you know, boutiques and stuff that I got now. But now I got the knowledge, and now I can produce and mass produce clothing. Like, I wasn't mass producing nothing when I was started the first season of Cranberry and Vodka. I was just basically doing one-offs in the special orders. When I slowed down, I just started doing one-offs that people wasn't biting because they was just so used to my creativity making shit, you know, as is. You know what I'm saying? But once I started, you know, I was like, all right, well, I'm going to have to figure out the way to still give them that same Cranberry and Vodka splash, but mass produce it now. You know what I'm saying? Okay. And I don't want it to, like, where everybody, like, it's 30, 40 niggas in the same sweat. So I don't think that's cool. I don't want to go to a cookout in the summertime or in the springtime somewhere in the function and got the same sweatsuit another guy got on. I don't really think that's fly.
Yeah, nah, you want to leave that shit like that. Well, one question, what made you get into clothes?
I always been a fly nigga. I always been into clothes. When I was young, I used to tie-dye t-shirts.
Yeah?
Yeah, I used to...
tie-dye is big right now.
I used to go to the little African spot and get like wild blank white tees and used to go to the grocery store or like an art and craft store and get any dye that I can find and get rubber bands and just read books, because at that time you ain't have YouTube, so read books, go to the library and read books on how to tie dye and how to, you know, actually make all these different shapes come out in the clothes and stuff. So I used to just do that as a hobby for me. Like, go there and make me a couple of shirts, come outside, niggas be like, ooh, you get that from? I'm like, yeah, I'm doing these shits in my kitchen. Mm-hmm. So that's where it started. Then I had a different technique of how I tie dye, because a lot of people, you know, they'll wrap the t-shirt in rubber bands and dip them in different dyes. I was doing the same thing, but I would go to the beauty supply store and get spray bottles and just add different paints and spray them, you know, spray them.
Creative with it.
Be creative, like spray them, you know, instead of dipping, because I felt that dipping would be, it just was like kind of sloppy. I didn't want to make a mess so much, so I found my own little technique the way.
You might be dropping a jewel on them, because they might be tie-dyeing something right now, like, because tie-dye is big right now, and like, you know what I mean? And the independent clothes industry is real big.
Let me tell you the secret with tie-dyeing. The secret with tie-dyeing is your wrap. The tighter your wrap, the tighter you tighten your rubber bands, you know what I'm saying? Because like traditional tie-dye is, you know, it's like the starburst, you know what I'm saying? It's like, mm-hmm. You know, how you do that is laying the t-shirt flat on the table, taking your hand in the middle of this t-shirt and turning it until it gets real small and tying it with rubber bands. Mm-hmm. And that's how you get the swirl effect in the t-shirt.
Wow.
If y'all did not know that, that's, you know what I'm saying? People that do fashion and know that. Even people that do tie-dye might even know that. They might be doing it another type of way, but that's the traditional way of tie-dyeing a t-shirt. You know what I'm saying? Taking it from the center of the t-shirt, twirling it until the t-shirt looks like a star itself in a little circular motion, then you wrap it with the rubber bands. And like I said, the tighter the rubber bands are, the better the print comes out, because after you take the rubber bands off the tie-dyeing, that's what makes the print, you know what I'm saying? So the tighter it is, the inks, the dye sets in the shirt, and that's what makes the print even better. So the tighter your rubber bands are, the doper your print is going to be. The looser your rubber bands is going to spread it out. You're just going to have a bunch of dye, and it's going to look good, you know what I'm saying? But if you want the traditional star and little circles and shit, that's how you do it.
Cool, that's some good info right there. That's real good. What else you got in work and into fashion? Or you got anything coming out in music and stuff like that? Hold on. Matter of fact, big shout out to YouTube, right? Because mm-hmm. You on YouTube all the time. What's the web series you on?
Shout out to my whole cast at the Brooklyn Way, DA Brooklyn Way. We got one of the biggest, most consistent web series out, you know.
Okay.
Mixed with real life and comedy. Shout out to Gat Murder for everybody. You know everybody, the whole cast.
Yeah, big shout out to Gat. We was with you today, Gat.
We got the, like I said, we got Cranberry and Vodka, Brooklyn Way, working on Vanilla Sky 3. You know what I'm saying? That's going to be like an A-song EP. That's going to be like the end of the Vanilla Sky series. And then I'm going to go on to something else. But I wrote a film years ago called Love Hurts. I think I finally want to materialize that. I want to get that piece of work out there. I think that's a piece that is missing from the film industry. You know what I'm saying? Like,
what's the name of it again?
Love Hurts. You know what I'm saying? I feel like would be stopping a lot of us in the film business is timing, and it's very hard to get a cast on the same page. That's why I say when you're doing a movie, make sure you got your cast is tight and people want the same, got the same hunger as you. That's how you get a film done, because filming is timing and it's real time consuming. And you basically want everybody on the same page, you know what I'm saying? Because, you know, it might be a day where everybody needs to be shooting. It's a 10-character cast. There's only six making it. So make sure, you know, you kind of structure your films out by days and cast members and making sure people's times is, you know, kind of equal to, you know, you can fit it out when you're making movies. That's what I learned by being on videos and movie sets. You got to have your cast together. You know,
super dope, super dope. You've been on a lot of video sets. You've been on a lot of movie sets. You really known in the industry as me. Like, you know, y'all know who I am, 1212 Vision. But y'all really know who this kid Unkasa is. And as I be with Unkasa, like, on a daily, because I really know you, as a friend and as a fan. You know what I'm saying? But when I'm hanging with you, you get a lot of fan love. Like, I see
that.
Like,
I appreciate that. It'd be like, it'd be kind of like overwhelming sometimes because...
Yeah, but don't say that, though, because you want that overwhelming love, you know?
Nah. I mean, the feeling for me, it'd be overwhelming.
Oh, that's
because,
good.
Because it'd be like... You know, when a lot of artists, and when you coming from the same walks of life that I came from, and you coming from the same era of music that I came from, a lot of us, all we really wanted was people to say we was nice or whatever we did sounded dope or shit like that. But when people walk up to you and tell you the music that you created is like the soundtracks of their life, is overwhelming, because it'd be like, yo, damn. A lot of times we don't even think the music is gonna go that far. We know somebody's gonna hear it, but we don't know this is gonna perhaps change somebody's life or their aspect in life. You know what I'm saying? We don't know. Like, sometimes when we make it, we might make music just for us or our niggas around us, but
But that's how powerful music
but
is.
That's what I was going to say. That's how powerful music travels. So it could be like, even before you have social media, like, people in Harlem heard about Nas way before his Illmatic tape came out, because his tape had leaked. And it was just certain niggas that was like, yo, it's this nigga from Queensbridge. You know, this nigga did a couple of joints with Large Professor and all that, but his tape is crazy. Like, that's how I first heard Illmatic. Like, I heard Illmatic on a bootleg.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Then, like, probably like a few months later, my best friend Mark had the original copy, and what attracted me to the tape deck, because there was a little kid on tape. I was like, yo, it's a little kid rapping. He's like, nah, it's L. He used a baby picture for his album cover. I was like, oh, that's L. I was like, yo, that's that Nas kid. We're like, yeah. And I think the bootleg probably had like five of his songs on it. I think Nas' album was like 12 songs, so I got to hear the rest of the album in its entirety. So that's what, you know, that's what turned me on about Nas right then. It was like, that was just the power of music, because, you know what I'm saying, Queensbridge is, you know, that's a whole nother borough. You know what I'm saying? Not saying it's far, but for music to travel and for other people from the same walks of life or just in different states of mind can get it, that shit is dope.
It is. It definitely is. One question, though. You got a top five favorite rapper? Favorite rappers? But even though, to say that, right, like, that's, for me, that's like a hard question to ask right now in this day and age, because it's like a whole different era to ask you that question, right?
It's just like... It's just like this. I'll tell you this. It's just like...
Because you came up in era.
A lot of people was afraid to accept that it's new blood in there. You know what I'm saying? You got to give it up to the new blood. It's just like, I came up in the era of Magic Johnson, Michael Jordan, Isaiah Thomas, Larry Bird. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
Now, I'm not even a sports guy, but I'm just trying to break it down. I don't even know a starting five or no team, because it's a bunch of new blood in, and that's good. You get what I'm saying?
Yeah.
It's a bunch of, it's like, we can't expect for something to stay the same for a long time.
Right, understood.
So it's just like, what my greats are might not be what this era greats are.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? We just gotta accept that it's a different time. Like, you know, our time, this time, this day and age that we in basketball, closest thing to Michael Jordan is LeBron James.
Right.
So
or Kobe.
Or Kobe. You right. know what I'm saying? So that's, you know what I'm saying? Me, Michael Jordan's the meanest motherfucker that ever touched the rock, but
that's other, a fact,
you
though.
Know what I'm saying? It's other guys. So like I said, it's a whole new blade. Like I love the new baby, the little babies, the babies. I like the Uzis. I like the Ray Shrimmets. I like the Young Thugs. I like the Gunners. The young G Herbos.
Damn near this whole new era. Some of them young like boys be Dirk. Spitting. Yeah, you Dirk is saying? Crazy.
I like all the new blood, but my top five is, you know, number one is definitely Big.
Yeah, you're a Big fan.
Big, Pac, Nas, Big Daddy Kane, Coogee Rap, Eazy-E. Like I grew up in an era where like it wasn't I ain't really it was just like I fucked with all of them, you know what I'm saying? But I definitely have my favorite all the time is like before Biggie was even came in the game, I was listening to shit like Leaders of the New School, Stetsasonic, Public Enemy.
I'm gonna keep it 100.
EPMD.
I only know about EPMD and Public Enemy.
You know what I'm saying? Jungle Brothers.
Like Leaders of the New School. How old were they? Like, yeah, I mean, whatever like, was that?
That was the early 90s. That was Busta Rhymes group.
Oh, word? That's what Busta
Rhymes. With Dico D and Sean right. Brown.
I remember that. You know what I'm saying? I didn't know their name.
Snickens. It was a whole bunch of shit out there that niggas didn't fuck with that was hip hop. A lot of niggas ain't fuck with the Food Snickens. A lot of niggas ain't fuck with, there was a lot of shit out there that niggas ain't fuck with, but it was still dope hip hop. You know what I'm saying? We had guys that coming up like Das Effects. We had Keith Murray. We had all type of dope, different shit that per se everybody ain't fuck with, but it was dope. We had Redman. We had Das Effects. We had, especially on that underground tip. We had Special A. You know what I'm saying? It was the different varieties of hip hop. And that's why I don't understand why everybody's so judgmental about today.
It's 1212 Vision, man.
1212 Vision Channel.
1212 Vision.
Yo, this is 1212 Vision Channel.